Hello everyone, welcome back in lecture series on topic solid state. In previous video we have studied about crystalline solids and characteristics of crystalline solids, and today in this video we are going to study classification of crystalline solid. So let us see first characteristics of crystalline solid. You know that crystalline solid, in case of crystalline solid, constituent particles are atom, ions and molecules. And arrangement of these constituent particle is regular and it is repeated periodically. These crystalline solids have long range order arrangement. And they have sharp melting point. Another important property of crystalline solid, that is, these are anisotropic in nature. All these characteristics we have studied last time. So let us move towards the classification of crystalline solids. So these crystalline solids are classified on the basis of 2 points, that is, constituent particles and interparticle forces of attraction. That is, force of attraction between atom, ion or molecule. So on the basis of constituent particles and interparticle forces of attraction, these crystalline solids are classified into 4 main types. Now, how they are classified? See here. First, that is ionic crystal. In case of ionic crystal, ions are constituent particle. And you know that 2 types of ions are there, positively charged and negatively charged. Positively charged ions are called as cations and negatively charged ions are anions. So, cations and anions are there. And these oppositely charged ions are bonded by ionic bonds. These are held together by ionic bond. So, interparticle force of attraction is ionic bond, or it is also called as electrostatic force of attraction, is there in between these oppositely charged ions in case of ionic crystals. Therefore, all salts are examples of these ionic crystals. Sagliji salts, like sodium chloride, potassium chloride, sodium nitrate, potassium nitrate, these are all ionic crystals. Then second one, that is covalent network crystal. In case of covalent network crystal, constituent particle is atom, and these atoms are linked or joined by covalent bond. They share the electron, mutual sharing is there, and they form a covalent bond. Examples: diamond, graphite, fullerenes, nanotubes, all these are silicon carbide, boron nitride, corundum, all these are the examples of SiO2 quartz. That is also the example of what? Covalent network crystal. Then third type, that is molecular crystals. In case of molecular crystal, constituent atom, constituent particle contain molecules. In case of molecular crystal, constituent particles are molecules. And in molecules, weak forces of attraction are there, such as dipole-dipole interaction, London disperse forces, or hydrogen bonding. These type of weak forces are there, and these forces hold these molecules together and form molecular crystal. So examples of molecular crystals: water molecule, CO2, CH4. All these are the examples of molecular solids or molecular crystal. And the fourth type, that is metallic crystal. In case of metallic crystal, metal atom is constituent part, and these metal atoms are held together by metallic bonds between positively charged metal ion and delocalized electron. So force of attraction between positively charged metal ion and delocalized electron is called as what? Metallic bond. So how these crystalline solids are classified? These are classified into four types on basis of what? On the basis of constituent particle and interparticle forces of attraction. Into these four types, that is ionic crystal, covalent network crystal, molecular crystal and metallic crystal. Now see here, the solids are classified into two types, crystalline and amorphous, and these crystalline solids are further classified into four types: molecular, ionic, metallic and covalent. And these molecular solids are again further classified as a polar, nonpolar and hydrogen bonded. So we will see that later on. Now first we will study ionic crystal. Now ionic crystal means what? Those crystals in which constituent particles are charged ion, and these charged ions are held by electrostatic force of attraction between oppositely charged ions is known as ionic crystals. For example, all salts, potassium sulfate, calcium fluoride, potassium chloride, sodium chloride, all these are the examples of salts. So these are the examples of ionic crystals. Now see here, in this picture, this green sphere, small green sphere is there, that is of sodium ion, and this large sphere, blue colored sphere, represent chloride ion. And there is a force of attraction between these oppositely charged ion, and their size may differ. Now see here, chloride ion has a larger size, whereas sodium ion has a smaller size, and these are alternately arranged in the crystal. So this is about ionic crystal. Now we will see the characteristics of ionic crystal. So first characteristic of ionic crystal, that is constituent particles are charged ion, that is cation and anion. So this is the sodium chloride crystal, and charge ion cation is sodium ion, chloride is the anion. So charge ion, these are the constituent particles of this particular ionic crystal. So in case of ionic crystal, charge particles or charge ions are the constituent particle. And second characteristic, that is these oppositely charged ions, these are held together by electrostatic force of attraction, that is also called as a Coulombic force. Now how it is developed? It is also called as an ionic bond. So how it is developed? See here. You know that this is a sodium atom, and atomic number of sodium atom is 11. So 11 electrons are there in a sodium atom. And chloride, this is the chlorine atom, green color sphere, and it has atomic number 17. So 17 electrons are there in the chlorine atom. Now what happens when they come close to each other? Then sodium transfer its electron, complete transfer of electron takes place. Sodium gives, donates electron to chloride, chlorine atom, and sodium forms sodium ion, plus one charge is there, sodium plus one ion is formed, and chlorine accepted electron and therefore it forms chloride ion by electron transfer. म्हणून बघा यांच्या साईजमध्ये फरक पडलाय. सोडियमवरचा एक इलेक्ट्रॉन गेला त्यामुळे सोडियमची साईज छोटी झाली आणि क्लोरीनने एक इलेक्ट्रॉन ॲक्सेप्ट केला त्याच्यामुळे क्लोरीनची साईज काय झालेली आहे इथे वाढलेली. सो साईज चेंज झालेली अँड दीज पॉझिटिव्ह अँड निगेटिव्हली चार्ज आयन आर अल्टरनेटली अरेंज इन द क्रिस्टल लॅटिस अँड देअरफोर द क्रिस्टल होल इज न्यूट्रल. देर इज नो चार्ज. चार्ज इज झिरो ऑन द क्रिस्टल कारण सेम नंबर ऑफ कॅटायन अँड एनायन आर प्रेझेंट इन द क्रिस्टल आयनिक क्रिस्टल. सो अपोजिटली चार्ज आयन्स आर हेल्ड टुगेदर बाय इलेक्ट्रोस्टॅटिक फोर्स ऑफ अट्रॅक्शन ऑर कुलंबिक फोर्सेस आर देर. देन द थर्ड कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ आयनिक क्रिस्टल दॅट इज आयनिक क्रिस्टल्स आर हार्ड अँड ब्रिटल and have high melting point. This is due to the arrangement of the ions in the crystal. Now, any ionic crystal, it consists of a parallel layers of positive and negatively charged ion like this. Here, positive and negative layers are alternately arranged and these are arranged over one another. When external force is applied, when you hammer it, then what happens? One layer slides over the another. And due to this, like charges come in front of each other. त्यामुळे काय होतं की पॉझिटिव्ह पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज निगेटिव्ह निगेटिव्ह चार्ज एकमेकांच्या समोर येतात. And you know that like charges repel. So due to repulsion between the like charges that crystal breaks and therefore ionic crystals are hard and brittle. As there is a strong forces of attraction these are hard but if you hammer it then these get break because of what these the like charges come in front of each other and therefore like charges repel and that crystal breaks and because of this arrangement they have high melting point because of the strong electrostatic force of attraction ionic crystals are hard and have high melting point and these are brittle. So this is the important property of ionic crystal and the fourth important property खूप महत्त्वाची ज्याच्यावर एम सी क्यू सुद्धा येऊ शकतो दॅट इज वॉट दीज आर नॉन कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इन सॉलिड स्टेट. बघा हां सॉलिड स्टेटमध्ये ते नॉन कंडक्टर आहे पण इफ इट इज मेल्टेड फ्यूज ऑर इफ इट इज डिझॉल्व्ड इन वॉटर देन दीज आर गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. वाय such a thing happens, why they show this the characteristic बघा इकडे सॉलिड स्टेटमध्ये काय असतं आयनची पोझिशन फिक्स असते. आयन्स आर फिक्स्ड इन द लॅटिस अँड दे कॅनॉट मूव. पास इलेक्ट्रिसिटी आयन्स शुड मूव देन ओनली इफ द आयन मूव देन ओनली दे कॅन कंडक्ट इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो as in case of solid state the position of ion is fixed they are non conductor of electricity but when these are melted or these are dissolved in the water then ions get separated positive and negative ions get separated and therefore they can move and therefore these are good conductor of electricity when melted or dissolved in water. पाण्यामध्ये डिझॉल्व केल्यानंतर आयन्स सेपरेट होतात आणि त्याच्यामुळे ते पॉझिटिव्ह किंवा निगेटिव्ह टर्मिनलकडे मूव होऊ शकतात किंवा जाऊ शकतात ट्रान्सफर होतात. पण सॉलिड स्टेटमध्ये तसं होऊ शकत नाही म्हणून ते काय आहेत नॉन कंडक्टर आहे अँड दीज आर गुड कंडक्टर when melted or dissolved in water. So thank you for watching this video. We will see the covalent network crystals next time.